remember when I first met you, sipping coffee in a corner booth. You were twirling your hair and I just had to stare for a minute or two. I was laughing at your stack of books, then you shot me that smile. Hey, beautiful girl, in your own little world, let me in it. You got all of my attention, you ain't even trying. Yeah, you're my kind of different, and I've never seen nothing like you. Rockin' that rock and roll t-shirt, party dressed up, but you just doing your thing. Ain't nobody ever seen nothing like you.
Seriously, naman po ito na lumakot. Nakikita ko po ang future ko na kasama si Perry. Gusto ko po siya makasama habang buhay. There's nothing more that I could ever ask for but for Perry to be my wife. Gusto ko po sana hingin sa inyo ang kamay ni Perry and yung blessings niyo po para po mapangasawa ko siya.
Iyo, sigurado ka ba sa desisyon mo? Kaya nyo na bang buhayin ang isa't isa at ang magiging anak ninyo ni Perry?
Lester, anak, wala namang kaso sa amin kung gusto mong pakasalan si Perry. Ang hiniling lang namin ay alagaan at mahalin mo siya ng lubusan tulad ng pagmamahal namin sa kanya.
Ama, kakaasa ko kayo.
Sige, umapayag na kami pakasalan mo si Perry.
Maraming salamat po.
So good afternoon. We are all here gathered today for us to be reminded what is the real purpose of marriage. The act of marriage is not only to love one another, but to celebrate God's unending mercy and to love for His people. I am Bethly May, your marriage counselor for this afternoon. I am here to guide you on what to prepare and acknowledge before getting married. So, here are some of the requirements needed. You are to sign some of the contracts to justify your marriage. Besides signing of papers, I am here to help you understand what is the real essence of sharing one love under God's mercy. The act of getting married shows how much you are willing to sacrifice yourself for the person and the other person is for you in a life whose future you may not know, whose obstacles that was once faced by one person now face together as one couple.
Come together in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of this man and this woman in holy matrimony. The bond and covenant of marriage was established by God in creation, and our Lord Jesus Christ adorned with this manner of life by His presence and first miracle at the wedding in Cana of Galilee. It signifies to us the mystery of the union between Christ and His Church, and Holy Scripture commands it to be honored among all the people. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for your mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity, and when it is God's will. For the procreation of children and their nurture in the knowledge and love of the Lord. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into unadvisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance with the purposes for which it was instituted by God. Into this holy union of Pearly Dawn for Melissa and Mark Lester Aguilera, now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they may not lawfully be married, speak now, or else before hold your peace. I require and charge you both, here in the presence of God, that if either of you now any reason why you may not be united in marriage lawfully, or in accordance with God's word, you do now confess it.
First reading, a reading from the book of Corinthians, verses 1 to 13. Excellence of the gift of love. Now I will show you the way which surpasses all the others. If I speak with human tongues and angelic as well, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong, a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and with full knowledge, comprehend all mysteries. If I have faith great enough to move mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. If I give everything I have to feed the poor and hand over my body to the burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous. It does not put on airs. It is not snobbish. Love is never rude, is not self-seeking. It is not prone to anger, neither does it brood over injuries. Love does not rejoice in what is wrong, but rejoices with the truth. There is no limit to love's forbearance, to its trust, its hope, its power to endure. Love never fails. Prophecies will cease. Tongues will be silent. Knowledge will pass away. Our knowledge is imperfect, and our prophesying is imperfect. When the perfect comes, the imperfect will pass away. When I was a child, I used to talk like a child, think like a child, reason like a child. When I became a man, I put childish ways aside. Now we see indistinctly, as in a mirror. Then we shall see face to face. My knowledge is imperfect now. Then I shall know, even as I am known. There are, in the end, three things that last: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Pearlie, will you have this man to be your husband, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, and forsaking others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Mark Lester, will you have this woman to be your wife, to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, and forsaking others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? I do. Will all of you, witnessing these promises, do all in your power to uphold these two persons in marriage? Let us pray. O gracious and ever-loving God, you have created us male and female in your image. Look mercifully upon this man and woman who come to you seeking your blessing, and assist them with your grace, that with true fidelity and steadfast love, they may honor and keep the promises and vows they make. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
In the name of God, I, Lester, take you, Pearlie, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until we are parted by death. This is my solemn vow.
In the name of God, I, Pearlie, take you, Lester, to be my husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, until we are parted by death. This is my solemn vow.
Bless, O Lord, this ring to be a sign of the vows by which this man and this woman have bound themselves to each other. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my love, and with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
I give you this ring as a symbol of my vow, and with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Now that Lester and Pearly have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with a joining of hands and the giving and receiving of a ring, I pronounce that they are husband and wife. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. O God, you have so consecrated the covenant of marriage that in it is represented the spiritual unity between Christ and His Church. Send, therefore, your blessing upon this your servants that may so love, honor, and cherish each other in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a heaven of blessing and peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully with His favor look upon you and fill you with all spiritual benediction and grace, that you may faithfully live together in this life and in the age to come, have life everlasting. Amen. Bless, O Lord, this ring to be a sign of the vows by which this man and this woman have bound themselves to each other. Ring, 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 ring,